So we're going to start from the absolute beginning. Before we even go into Vizrt Artist, I'm going to start in Photoshop to create a couple of assets or images for myself to use within this project. Now I know that I want my scenes to look a certain way, so I'm going to go ahead and create a couple of images that are going to help me achieve this. The first thing that I did, or the first thing that I do know, is that I kind of want an image to work as a backplate or something dark. So what I did is I went to a stock photo site, I purchased this image of this black background here. I'm going to use this throughout my design, but when I come to my image size here, it says it's 1600 by 1600. It's too big to use in Viz as it is, because with Viz, we're always thinking about performance and optimization. We want our images to be as small as we possibly can. However, in this particular case, I know that I may need this as a background, so I'm going to make it a little bit bigger. I'm going to go ahead and just say this is going to be 640 by 640. So here's my new image. I'm going to go ahead and just drag this picture that I bought into here. I'm going to scale it down so that it's going to fit into the 640 range. So here I have my scale. Let's just bring it down a little, about halfway, and we'll just constrain it until it fits into our area here, almost perfectly square, pretty close. And once I have it where I want it, I'm just going to go ahead and save it in a folder that Vizrt has access to. I'm going to go ahead and call this BG1. I'm just going to save it as a TIFF. No need to save the layers. I also want to do the same image, however, just offset the texture a bit or have a different texture. So I'm just going to drag this image over again. You can see this time the texture is a bit bigger. So I'm just going to save it as is like this. So I'm going to go ahead and save this again, and we're going to call this one BG2. Again, I'll save it as a TIFF, no need to save the layers, and close it. All right, so that's it for that one. Now we're going to create an accent color here. So I'm just creating a new swatch. I'm going to say this time it's going to be 400 by 400. And what I just basically want to do is create some type of color or gradient here. And I'm going to use this green to chartreuse color here. So I'm just going to come into my image and create a green swatch. This green swatch, however, I want to have an alpha channel. So I'm going to go ahead and create an alpha channel with this so that we'll have a key or alpha channel in Vizrt with this image. Now with my alpha channel, I also want to feather a little bit. So I'm just going to go ahead and hit select, modify, feather, and let's do 4 pixels. We'll hit OK. We'll go into our channels and create the alpha channel here. I'm going to go ahead and save this. I'll name it green swatch, and we're going to go ahead and save it as a TIFF without the layers, but we'll keep the alpha channels so that we can import that into Viz. I'm done with that. I'm going to go ahead and close it. I'm going to create one more image here, and it's just going to be an off-white image. I'm going to make it even smaller. We're going to go 128 by 128. And I'm just going to come into my layers, create a new layer, maybe just a little bit off-white. So I'll use my paint bucket here to grab a quick light gray color, and we'll fill it. I'm also going to add a little bit of an inner shadow to this. So I'll come into my layer styles here and just add our inner shadow to it. I'll make some quick adjustments here just to kind of get it where you want. However, you can make yours however you want. You don't necessarily have to do the exact same thing as I'm doing. This is pretty close for me. I'm just going to leave it as is and go ahead and save this here. And I'll call this our white swatch. And again, I'll just save it as a TIFF without the layers, and we'll hit save. Our next step will be going into Vizrt Artist and importing these images so that we can begin building our scenes.